Today I'll talk about a very common misconception in the hydroponic industry. Not for people who are experienced growers, but for people who are trying to get into the industry and who are reading too much numbers on Google without trying to understand the science behind the plants. And the misconception is, the more the number of plants, the higher will be the yield and higher will be the revenue. Friends, it's not about the number of plants. If you have two farms of same size, it is quite possible that the farm which has a smaller number of plants will be more profitable than the farm which has large number of plants. And I'm not even saying that these two farms are going to different crops. Let's say you have two farms of 40-acre size. One has 15,000 plants and all of the plants they are growing is 100 meters. And the other farm has 20,000 plants in 40-acre and they are also growing 100 meters. It's possible and not even possible, from my experience I'm telling you, in all likelihood, the farm having 15,000 plants will be more profitable than the farm having 20,000 plants. Sounds difficult? Let me tell you why. Please understand, every plant needs different things to survive and grow. One part of that is nutrition, right? The second part of that is sunlight, which is required to do photosynthesis. The third part of that is transpiration. The amount of water that the plant takes out, it needs to go out of its, the body of the plant. The process of transpiration needs to happen for the plant to grow. Now, if you cram too many plants together, yes, you will have more number of plants, but they will not be able to grow to your true size. So in our example, the first farm which had 15,000 plants, most likely each butterhead lettuce that they will harvest will be of around 200 grams minimum. The weight will range between 200 to 300 grams. And the farm which had 20,000 plants, they will hardly reach 120, 130 grams. Let me explain to you with an example. See, this is this chart. Now, if you see here, in this particular channel, there are 20 planting holes. And every planting hole is being used. Since we have harvested, we continue harvest, you are not seeing the density here, but look at the density here. It looks good. Now compare it with bok choy. This bok choy also is looking good density. But if you look closer, come and see here. If you look closer, you will see that instead of 20, we only have 10 plants per channel in this bed. Now again look at both the beds. Both the beds show good density of plant. But in this bed, I am only using 10 plants in your channel. And in this bed, I am having 20 plants in a channel. So essentially, it's not about the number of plants. And this particular bed may actually give me more weight than if I was growing bok choy in this bed. Because then the bok choy will not be able to grow and add weight. Most of the weight of the plant is added during the last phase of the plant life, the last year. Look at the size of this bok choy. Look at the size. If I would have put 20 plants, all of those plants would have grown. But I would have to sell those plants when they were about one third of the weight of this plant. So this one plant is equivalent to three smaller plants for me. So guys, when you are trying to figure out how to maximize your profit, which is something you should try to do, don't just look at the number of plants. The right question to ask is not how many plants I will have in my farm. The right question to ask is, if this is the farm plan, if these are the crops I want to grow, then how many plants I should have in my farm?